Hello and welcome to this demonstration in the course for Secure Systems Engineering. In this demonstration, we'll be looking at a ROP attack. Now, ROP attacks are extremely difficult to do. So we'll be just glimpsing about one particular assignment, which was submitted by some of the students in the course when I was actually teaching it. So this assignment, essentially it worked with a file in this directory called ROP, and you can actually download this file. It is part of the VM which comes along with this course, and in the VM in the directory NPTEL codes module 4 ROP, you'd actually find this required code. So the file that was attacked was tut2.c, or it's actually tutorial2.c, and this essentially did a lot of things. There was a main and there was a concatenate first chars, the function, and I have to give credit to the students who wrote this code, so their roll numbers are present here. The right working of this code is as follows. So this is the executable tutorial 2. It inputs 10 words as like this. And the output is the first characters of every input word. So you see over here that the first characters A, B, C, D to J are actually printed out on the screen. So this is what this program actually does. And there is a vulnerability in this particular program. The vulnerability is present in this function concatenate first chars. We will not go into what the vulnerability is, but we leave it as an assignment and as a challenge to any of the viewers to actually try to find out this vulnerability in this function. But what we will see over here is we will try to build an ROP attack which uses that vulnerability. So the aim of the ROP attack is to somehow compute 10 factorial. As you know, 10 factorial is the product of numbers from 1 to 10. So the aim of this attack is to determine or compute 10 factorial using ROP gadgets and fill in the value of the result in this global variable GLB. So this GLB value would be printed somewhere over here, print GLB. And you can actually look at this file and note that nowhere in the file we are actually using GLB anywhere else except in this printf. And also note that we are not computing 10 factorial or any other factorial anywhere in this particular program. Okay, so starting with the ROP attack. The first thing to do with an ROP attack is to identify the gadgets which are present in the program. So the gadgets can be obtained using a particular tool which is present in this directory, ROP gadget master. You can go to this ROP gadget master, and use the tool python ROP gadget.py, specify a binary as the input, and provide the path to the executable which you want to evaluate. So what this gadget tool would do, the ROP gadget tool would do, was that it would parse through the entire executable tutorial 2 and identify all possible gadgets that it can find. So we can just redirect the output into this file E1. Okay, and we'll open E1 and see that these are the gadgets that the tool found. Okay, so note that each of these gadgets has a few instructions and then has a return or a return F or a call instruction at the end. This particular address over here is the address of the particular gadget. So, as you see, the tool has found a large number of gadgets present in the executable tutorial 2, and in fact, there are like 13,276 gadgets that are present. Now, coming back to the payload that we want to write, we want to compute 10 factorial using these gadgets. So essentially what we need to do is pick out gadgets from these 13,276, arrange them in a manner on the stack so that in the end 10 factorial is computed. So, we'll not go into details about how we are actually picking up this gadget, but we'll just see a report on this. So, the report is present over here. Okay, so we just go look at this report for the entire attack, and what we see over here is the contents of the stack, and this is the contents of the stack when the function concatenate first chars is being executed. So, as we know that when this function is executed, there is a stack frame which is active, and this frame looks something like this way. So, there is the return address which is stored, which is of 4 bytes. Then there is the previous frame pointer, essentially the frame pointer corresponding to main. Then there is some other data and locals which are present. So, for our specific compilation, the locations of the stack and the stack frame are present as follows over here. But when you run it or when you actually try to execute this program, you may get a different value for these addresses. However, the structure of the stack and the relativeness of where the various data are present on the stack would be identical. So, what an ROP attack actually does is that it replaces this return to main and starts filling in gadgets over here. So, starting from the first gadget which is placed at this point, you would have gadgets going upwards like this, such that each of these gadgets have some operation in computing the 10 factorial. The gadgets that we use are actually there are 14 of them picked from the space of the 13,000 odd gadgets which are found in tutorial 2 using the gadget tool, and these are the 13 gadgets which were used. So, these gadgets varied in functionality from very simple things like return, which is equivalent to just doing a no op operation, to something which is much more complicated like this gadget number 6, which is essentially integer multiplication. It multiplies some contents pointed to by this ECX register with the EAX register. The description of each of these gadgets is present over here. So, what we do in order to compute 10 factorial is we select gadgets and start to build a sequence of operations which we place on the stack such that after all of these gadgets complete its execution, we would be able to complete or obtain 10 factorial. The modified stack with all gadgets placed, it looks something like this. So, it starts from gadget number 1 placed in this location. This location originally had the return to main which we had seen, and now we overflow a buffer and replace this return to main with a sequence of gadgets. So, what happens during execution is first gadget 1 executes, and the return in gadget 1 would pick this address from the stack which corresponds to gadget 2 and execute. Then gadget 3, gadget 4 and so on executes in such a way. This sequence of placing the gadgets is in such a way so that at the end of this sequence, 10 factorial is computed. To be more specific, for example, each of these sequences, for example, at this position, we would have computed 3 factorial, and the result for 3 factorial would be placed in the global variable GLV. Here to here, from the gadgets GA9 present in this location to the gadget GA8 over here, we would compute 4 factorial. So this is evident from this move EAX to 4. And then to the contents of GLV, we multiply 4, and therefore, after a few more gadgets, we would have stored 4 factorial in GLV. Now, this is repeated several times in a sequence of like 5, 6 and so on until the entire 10 factorial is computed. The one hurdle which one would probably face while trying to do this is that the stack segment may actually overflow, for instance, because this is the second function which is invoked soon after main. Therefore, the contents of the stack is relatively small, and if we keep adding gadgets onto this stack, the stack may quite easily overflow and a thing will not work. So it is quite a tricky way to choose gadgets and place gadgets in such a way so that the required payload gets executed. So let us see how this thing works. We will not go into details about the internals of this because it is extremely complex and essentially out of scope for this particular course. But we will just run this, and the input is this, the input where the gadgets are placed is in this file input VM. So it's a binary file, so we could open it with the octal dump of it, and this is how, this is what the input is actually used to the tutorial program. So let us see how this ROP gadget actually executes. So there's a payload underscore vm.py. We'll just have a look at that and see that this particular code arranges the gadgets and forms the required input, which is placed in Y in this string Y over here, and finally Y gets printed. So this particular Python script, you could actually go through it to see how these gadgets are arranged, and eventually the file that gets created is this file called input.vm. So we run this tutorial to give it this malicious input, which is input underscore VM, and we see that the value in GLB is 3628800. This essentially is the value for 10 factorial, which you can actually verify. So one problem in this code is that there is a segmentation fault, and after the 10 factorial gets printed, and this is because the program was not terminated in a safe way or with a nice exit. So I would leave an assignment or a very hard challenge, one of the most difficult challenges in this course, is to modify this particular code in such a way that the ROP gadget terminates in a graceful way. Thank you.